Hey guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. It's your girl Fanny Lungu, back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. So today I'm going to be reacting to, are all religions equal, or is there supremacy of one religion over other religions? Dr. Zaki Naik. I think I've reacted something like this, but anyway, so that's what we are reacting to. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
Good evening and salam alaikum to everyone. I'm Councillor Naveen Shah, leader of Hero Council. I'd like to give a very warm welcome to Zakir Bhai on behalf of Hero Council and multicultural, multi-faith community of Hero. You're very, very welcome. Since I'm limited to one question, I will follow the discipline. It's been very thought-provoking address. I'm very grateful for that. You have analyzed to some degree of detail various religions, the Islam, the Hinduism, Judaism, and even atheists. Is it a question of equality of religions, or do you reckon that there is a case for supremacy of one religion against another? Thank you.
The brother asked a very good question. That is there a question of supremacy of one religion over the other religion? Basically, what is the meaning of the word religion? Religion means a way of life. I rather believe what the Quran says. Rather than talking about supremacy, the Quran says, Talawila kalmitin sawa im baina bainakum. Come to common terms as been us and you. If there is a question of supremacy, then each one will try and prove that religion is the best. So rather the Quran advises when we speak with people following other religion, is talawila kalmitin sawa im baina bainakum. Come to common terms as been us and you. So I personally disagree with the interfaith dialogues that take place normally in the world. Normally what happens is that there is a person coming from the Christian faith, priest, and coming that all religions are the same. Christianity is the same, Hinduism is the same, Islam is the same. Then you have a Hindu pandit coming and saying Hinduism is also correct and same, Islam is the same, Christianity is the same. Then they get Joker Muslim who comes and says that Islam is the same, Hinduism is the same, Christianity is the same. See, I being a student of Islam and compared religion, it's a big lie to say that all religions are the same. There are commonalities, but they aren't the same. There are differences. I can talk more about differences than the similarities, but the Quran encourages to talk about similarities. What my strategy is, brother, that I tell that at least let us agree that one religious scripture is 100% perfect. So the Christian will say, fine, I don't mind believing that Bible is 100% the word of God. The Hindu would say, I would not mind believing the Vedas to be the word of God. The Muslim will say, I don't mind considering Quran to be the word of God. I'm not trying to put anything on the top of somebody's head, not going to put anything down the throat. Now what I say, that what is common in all these scriptures, at least let us agree to follow that strictly. What is different, we'll discuss it later on. So when we come and try and find the commonalities in all these scriptures, we find that the commonality is the same. All of the religious scriptures say believe in one God. I gave you references from the Bible. Bible, Moses, peace be upon him, said in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 6, verse number 4, Shama Israelo, Adnehin Adnechad. Hear, O Israel, the Lord, our God, is one Lord. When Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is asked that which is the first of the commandment, he repeated verbatim, the same thing in the Gospel of Mark, chapter number 12, verse number 29, Shama Israelo, Adnehin Adnechad. Which means, Yoro Israel, the Lord, our God, is one Lord. If you read the Hindu scriptures, if you read the Upanishads, it's mentioned Chandogya Upanishad, chapter number 6, section number 2, verse number 1, Ekam Evidityam. It's a Sanskrit quotation which means, God is one without a second. It's mentioned in the Shweta Shatar Upanishad, chapter number 6, verse number 9, Nachasya Kasij Janita Nachadipa, which means, of that God, he has got no superior, he has no Lord, he has got no parents. He has got no mother, he has got no father, he has got no superior. It's mentioned in Shweta Shatar Upanishad, chapter number 4, verse number 19, Natasipati Ma Asti. Of him, there is no images. I can give quotation from Bhagavad Gita, Upanishad, Veda, several, talking about oneness of God. So I say that why don't all of us believe in one God? Bhagavad Gita chapter number 7 verse number 20 says that all those whose intelligence has been stolen by material desires, they worship demigods, they do idol worship. So if you read the Vedas and Bhagavad Gita and the Upanishads, they say there's one God. It's against idol worship. They don't believe in Almighty God coming down. They believe in Almighty God sending messengers. So I say that let us, the Hindus, the Jews, the Christians, the Muslims, at least believe that we worship none but one Almighty God. And that God has got no images. He cannot be begotten. It's mentioned in the Bible. It's mentioned in Bhagavad Gita. It's mentioned in the Quran. If you studied all these scriptures, the next point you come to know, which is common, is that there's going to come a final and last messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. I give you quotations in my lecture about Judaism and Christianity. I can give you references even from the Hindu scriptures. If you read Bhavishya Purana, Parva 3, Khanda 3, Adhyay 3, Shlokas 10 to 27, it speaks about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You speak about Kuntab Suktas, Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 127, verse number 1 to 14, speak about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. There is a book called as Kalki Purana. It speaks about an avatar, a Kalki avatar to come. It's mentioned in the Hindu scriptures in Kalki Purana that there is a final avatar, Antim Rishi, last messenger going to come, whose mother's name shall be Sumati, which means peaceful, which means Amina. It says the father's name shall be a one who worships Almighty God. Vishnu Yash, translating to Arabic, it means Abdullah, the name of the parents of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It says that he will be born on the 12th month of Madhav, which is 12th Rabbi Awal. It says that he will be the last and final messenger, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, last and final messenger. It says that he'll be held with four companions, talking about the first four caliphs of Islam. And on, he'll be born in the place which is known as peaceful, Sambhala, which is Makkah. He'll be born in the family of the chief of Makkah. I've given the talk on Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam Hindu scriptures. So second point of commonality is according to me, after being one God, you have to follow the last and final messenger to come. That is Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It speaks about life after death. The Jewish scriptures, Christian scriptures, Hindu scriptures and Islam. When Hindu scripture speaks about Punarjanam, it speaks about next life. It doesn't speak about life, death. That's a misconception. Punar means next. Janam means life. We believe in life after death, but not being born and death, born, dying. That's a misconception. So what I say, at least let us agree what is common. So all the major religious scriptures, whether it be Judaism, Christianity, Hinduism, Islam, speak about one God and speak about a final messenger to come whose name shall be Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So if all of them follow the last and final messenger, they'll have to follow the revelation given to him, have to follow the Quran. So rather than talking about supremacy, we have to go back. There's only one religion. And the one religion, as Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 19, Inna deena indallahi al-Islam. The only religion acceptable in the sight of Almighty God is submitting your will to Almighty God. Islam. Submitting your will to Almighty God. It's not a label. A person, by keeping his name Muhammad, Sultan, Abdullah, Zakir, he will not go to heaven just by having a Muslim name. Muslim is a person who acquires peace by submitting his will to Almighty God. So all the religious scriptures that came previously, brother, by the passage of time, they have been changed. Quran is the last and final revelation which has been kept in its pure form. But in spite when all the other scriptures have been changed, according to the scholars, you read the books of Hindu scholars, of Christian scholars, they say the scriptures have been changed. But even after they have been changed, there are remnants of truth in them, which speak about the last and final message of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and talking about one God. So if you go back to your scriptures and at least follow the commonalities, then nothing like supremacy will culminate only to one religion, that is submitting our will to Almighty God. Hope that answers the question.
Love this video very much. I mean, thank you, Dr. Zaki Naik. Let's find the common parts of every religion and put it in practice. Let that be the reason why we coexist. So stop thinking that one religion is better than the other, or this is higher than. There's no hierarchy when it comes to religion, as you said. And I love how you explained this from different religions to just makes sense that at the end of the day, we're praying to one God. There's only one God. There's no idols. There's no images. There's nothing. And that was very, very amazing to hear. Let me know what you guys think. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it to the friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.